In his fifth State of the Union address, U.S. President Obama referred to 2014 as a breakthrough year for the United States of America. In order for it to be a breakthrough year, what he needs is political consensus, the support of Republicans. This may be a demand too exacting. In a year which is an election year, the House is up for re-election and one-third of the Senate, especially at a time when there is a risk that the Democrats may lose the Senate, in which case the House and the Senate would both be Republican and united against the President. While seeking political consensus and the cooperation of Republicans in the Congress, Obama also threatened to bypass Congress and to do whatever he could, which he felt was necessary, through administrative action if legislative cooperation was not forthcoming. By referring to the achievements of ordinary Americans, and even more so their travails, the difficulties that they face, thought of the Aam Aadmi of America, he said that it was necessary to raise wages and that federal contractors would begin to pay $10.10 per hour, and challenged the rest of the economy, especially in states, to raise minimum wages. He said that America needed to invest in education, particularly in education for the very young, as the long-term investment in the economic future of the country. He celebrated the major increase in oil production, which for the first time had brought America to a situation where domestic production was greater than the imported oil, and said that it was making the onshoring of jobs, the return of manufacturing to America possible. He hoped that this would also increase employment opportunities and really what they talk about as the jobs that enable people to stay in the middle class. He also called for a reform in surveillance. Yet again, he meant only surveillance of ordinary Americans rather than the rest of the world, which has so offended many of America's friends and allies. But in fact, nothing new was suggested, especially as he had made detailed recommendations last week, none of which actually cut down the powers of the agency which carried out surveillance. To come to those areas in his address which concern the rest of the world, Obama claimed success for ending wars that America had been involved in for the last 12 years. He did say that they would remain committed to Afghanistan and hope to leave behind a small force, but put the onus of signing an agreement on President Karzai of Afghanistan without any sense that the Americans too would make concessions in the negotiations. He also referred to the importance of the agreement with Iran, by which he claimed that Iran's program, which would enable it to make bombs in the future, was now being reversed and being rolled back. He linked this to the unflinching support to the security of Iran, beyond pro forma references to the strength of the alliance with the European partners, with the intent to stay focused on the Asia-Pacific. There was not much reference to any of the other issues which so absorbed the rest of the world. It was very clearly a case of an American president focusing on rebuilding of America, which is really the intent and where President Obama's heart lies. So it is very much a message to the rest of the world that you are on your own, and a message which many countries, especially in Asia, will take, that the United States is not about to begin confronting China.